you have ever wondered what the heck a dietitian buys at the grocery store, this is the video for you. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Melissa. I'm a registered dietitian, and here on my channel, we talk about all things food and nutrition. Today, we are doing a good old grocery haul. I haven't done one of these in a really long time. I feel like I used to do them more often, but yeah, today I went to Harris Teeter and Trader Joe's, and I bought pretty much all of our groceries for the week. And yeah, let's just jump into it. Let's start with Harris Teeter just because I got the bulk of the stuff there. And then Trader Joe's is just kind of supplementing it, which is normally how I do shop. Most of the stuff I'll get at Harris Teeter or like a normal grocery store. And then Trader Joe's, I'll get more specialty items and things like that. I don't love buying like produce at Trader Joe's just because it's all packaged in plastic. And yeah, so I just try to buy most of my stuff at Harris Teeter. So first up is just a good old bag of spinach. I guess I'll tell you what I'm using all of it for. I'll also link any recipes that I'm following below as well. So this week I'm going to make a like lentil curry soup thing for my lunches. So this is for that. I also got some yogurt. I have yogurt pretty much every morning for breakfast. So I got some Faye 2%. This is just plain Greek yogurt, and I put some berries and some peanut butter and hemp seeds in there, and that is my breakfast for the morning. One of these typically lasts me, if not the whole week, like 4 days. So yeah, this is technically 4 servings in here, so sometimes it'll last me the whole week, just depending on how hungry I am in the morning. I got some strawberries. I got these for dessert. Oh, I just realized I forgot to get whipped cream. I was gonna have strawberries and whipped cream for dessert, but now I don't have whipped cream. But I can still have strawberries. For that lentil soup recipe, I got a thing of red lentils. I got some extra firm tofu. I am making this like vegan Parmesan crusted tofu with some pasta, which I made, I think 2 weeks ago, and it was so, so good. So I'm making that again this week. Again, I'll link that recipe below, but I got a pack of extra firm tofu for that. And also for that, I got some panko breadcrumbs. We are going to have tacos one night, and we love chorizo tacos. So I got some chorizo. This is just such an easy meal. It's not like the healthiest by any means, but it's incredibly easy. Just throw some of this in the frying pan and then just put it in taco shells, and that's pretty much it. So we're gonna do that one night this week. I also got some cotija cheese. Is this how we pronounce it? I don't know. I always thought it was cojita, but I just realized that is not how it's spelled. So cotija cheese. I'm making some like Mexican, I think the recipe said it was like Mexican street cauliflower or something to go with the tacos. And I also just realized the cauliflower must have fallen out of my bag in my car. So know that I also got cauliflower. It's just not in my bag right now. But I got some of this cheese to like sprinkle on top of the cauliflower. For the lentil soup, I got some coconut milk. The recipe said to use whole fat coconut milk. I ended up just getting the light coconut milk. I like my soups and stuff to be extra soupy, and I feel like with the whole coconut milk, it's a lot thicker. So I like more of a thinner consistency, and that's just personal preference. And then I also got some diced tomatoes for that soup recipe as well. Vegetable stock for the soup recipe as well. An onion for a couple different things. I'm making a frittata one night, which I already had eggs, so you will not see eggs in this grocery haul. Also for the soup recipe, for the tacos and the Mexican cauliflower, I also got some sour cream. Love me some sour cream. And then to make as a side with the frittata that I'm making, I got some asparagus. Roasted asparagus is something we have pretty much every week. It's so easy and it's a really good side. So this is kind of a go-to side item for us. All right, and that is what I got from Harris Teeter. Like I said, I already have eggs for the frittata. I also already had all of the spices that I need for the lentil soup recipe. So yeah, that's why you don't see those in this haul. All right, on to Trader Joe's. I got some of this Malabari paratha. Again, I'm probably pronouncing that wrong. I very much apologize. Indian bread, it's frozen from Trader Joe's. I already said that, I think. But this bread is so freaking good. And I love, especially with like a lentil soup or something like that, especially like an Indian kind of spiced lentil soup, I do love to have like a piece of bread on the side with it. And I was gonna get naan bread, but this bread I like better for some reason. So I ended up getting this to have like on the side with my lentil stuff. Oh, here's the cauliflower from Harris Teeter. It ended up in the Trader Joe's bag. So had a cauliflower for that Mexican street cauliflower recipe I was gonna make with the tacos. I just got some unsweet almond milk. I think I do need this for that Parmesan tofu recipe. I also like to just have it for like protein shakes or if I wanna make a smoothie or something. This is always good to just have in the fridge. For the frittata that I'm making, I got some cubed butternut squash. We've been really liking what have I been putting in it? Butternut squash, spinach, onion, and goat cheese. And that's what's in the frittata, and I've been really enjoying that. My fiance is really enjoying it, so I'm gonna make that type of frittata again. I do have frozen spinach as well. I like to get this butternut squash from Trader Joe's just because the butternut squash they have at Harris Teeter is such a huge pack of cubed squash, and I feel like I can never use it all before it goes bad. So I like, this is a smaller version. And also like, I just, your girl does not want to chop butternut squash. That doesn't sound fun. So I'm getting it cubed, sorry. I also got some tortillas. This is the whole, these are whole wheat, high fiber tortillas from Trader Joe's. Some nutritional yeast. And this is for that Parmesan crusted tofu recipe. Last time I made that recipe, I was going to try to just use like regular Parmesan because I've tried nutritional yeast before and it's never really like done anything for me. But then I decided, you know what, I'll just try it. And it was really good and it did taste cheesy and delicious. But I was out of that one, so I decided to get another one. I haven't bought nutritional yeast at a regular grocery store, but I feel like Trader Joe's with like specialty kind of items like this, like nutritional yeast or like chia seeds, things like that, I feel like they have a much better price. I think this was only $2.99, and something that is such like a kind of health food thing from a regular grocery store, I feel like would be marked up a lot. So like I said, haven't bought it at a regular grocery store, but I feel like $2.99 is probably a really good price for that from Trader Joe's. I also bought some red lentil pasta from Trader Joe's. I haven't actually got this in a really long time. We normally use bonza, which is delicious. I love bonza, but my Harris Teeter doesn't have it, and I didn't feel like going to a million different grocery stores to get it. I know Target does have it, but I figured I was at Trader Joe's, I might as well just get this one. So this is the red lentil pasta. Oh, I just realized my lunches are gonna be red lentil too. Having a lot of red lentils this week. And that's all of like the meal stuff that I got, but I just got a couple like snack things, literally two. I got some Rainbow's End trail mix from Trader Joe's. I mean, I don't know about you guys, but I love a classic trail mix that has like the M&Ms and then the almonds and peanuts. This is my favorite kind of trail mix. Not anything fancy, just delicious. So I got some of that. And then finally, I've been seeing this like every time I go to Trader Joe's, and we mentioned possibly having breakfast for dinner one night this week. I don't think we will just because I have all this other stuff, but just for the future if we want it. I got this buttermilk protein pancake mix. I like the packaging, it's very cute. But yeah. Never tried this before, gonna give it a try. It says it has 10 grams of protein and 29 grams of whole grains in two pancakes. Just add water. Oh, it has whey protein in it. Interesting. Yeah, so I don't know, we'll see. Have you guys ever tried this? Is it good? I will find out eventually. But yeah, so that is everything I got at the grocery store. That will take care of all of my meals, maybe minus one that I'm gonna get at Costco for the entire week, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. That'll take care of all my meals for the entire week, minus we normally go out to eat on Friday and Saturday. So besides that, that should take care of everything. So yeah, that is my groceries for the week. I hope that you enjoyed this video. I love seeing what other people buy, so hopefully you do too. Give it a thumbs up if you did like this. And yeah, let me know what other kinds of videos you want to see. Thank you so much for watching. And oh yeah, subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you next week. Bye.